गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टडी अबाउट द इफेक्ट ऑफ लाइट ऑन द प्लांट्स। लाइट प्लेज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन प्लांट लाइफ। नियरली ऑल द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ प्लांट लाइफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, फॉर्म, शेप, फिजियोलॉजी, ग्रोथ, रिप्रोडक्शन, डेवलपमेंट, लोकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एट्सेट्रा आर कंट्रोल्ड बाय it. Based on light factor alone, plants can be divided into two groups. Shade tolerant plant species called as sclerophytes and shade intolerant species that is heliophytes. Sclerophytes have lower growth rate and lower respiration rate. The role of light on plant life may be as follows. Effect of light on photosynthesis, respiration, opening and closing of stomata and in transpiration, growth and flowering of plants, in which long day plants, short day plants, day neutral plants, heliophytes, sclerophytes. Role of light on movement of plants, germination of seed, effect on the production of chlorophyll, effect on number and position of chloroplast, effect on leaf structure, effect on growth, effect on development of flowers, fruits and seeds, and lastly the effect on the distribution of plants. First one, that is effect on photosynthesis. Out of the total solar energy reaching the earth, only about 2% is used in photosynthesis and about 10% is used in other physiological activities. All wavelengths of light are not utilized by a plant. Green light is completely reflected by green parts of the plant, making them looking green. Red and blue green are the two maxima of absorption of light. The green plants, the producers of ecosystem, synthesize their food from water and carbon dioxide in presence of sunlight. The solar radiations provide energy for this process. In this process, the radiant energy of sun available to the plant is converted into the chemical energy by chloroplast. Second effect on respiration. There is no direct effect of light on the respiration. Indirect effect is much important because in presence of light, the respiratory substrates are synthesized. Under certain conditions, such as in shade and underwater, the light becomes a limiting factor and the photosynthesis is not sufficient for effective growth. Under such conditions, the rate of photosynthesis is just sufficient to meet the need of respiration. This is called compensation point. At this point, the dry weight of plant does not increase. In many plants, the respiratory rate increases with the increase in the light intensity. However, in some other plants, respiration rate decreases slightly in intense light. The rise and fall of respiration rate may be due to the effect of light on the permeability of plasma membrane, change in the viscosity of the protoplasm, and photooxidation of enzymes. Then opening and closing of stomata and in transpiration. Mostly the stomata remain open in the light and close in the dark. Light brings about photophosphorylation and conversion of starch into soluble sugars in the guard cells and thereby increases their osmotic pressure, which in turn causes inflow of water in the guard cells. The increase in the turgidity of guard cells causes widening of gap between two guard cells. The opening of stomata increases the gases exchange and also increase the rate of transpiration during day period. Increase in the light intensity above the optimum shows detrimental effect because the increased transpiration in the intense light is injurious to plants. Next, growth and flowering of plants. Light shows many effects on the growth of plants. Growth of plant depend especially on the intensity, quality, duration and direction of light. High intensity of light inhibits the production of auxins or growth hormones, and consequently it influences the shapes and size of plant. Plants growing in darkness or insufficient light produce maximum amount of growth hormones, as a result of which they are elongated with slender pale yellow stem and small leaves. The plant's growth is slow in light of high intensity. Red light favors the growth. Lights of shorter wavelength except violet are detrimental to plant growth. The light duration. Duration of light is also very important. Actual duration or length of day, that is photoperiod, has been shown to be important factor in the growth and flowering of wide varieties of plant. The controlling effect of the photoperiod according to their response to photoperiod, the plants have been classified into three well-defined groups: long day plants, short day plants and day neutral plant. The plants which flower or bloom when the light duration is more than 12 hours per day are called long day plants. Example, radish, potato and spinach. In short day plants, they flower or bloom when the light duration is less than 12 hours per day. Example is cereals, tobacco, cosmos, dahlia. Day neutral plants. Plants which show little response to length of daylight are called day neutral plants. For example, cotton, balsam, tomato plant. The plants which receive sunlight or direct sunlight are called heliophytes, and the plants which grow in shade are called sclerophytes. In nature, the effect of light is uniform over wide area, and therefore it is not likely to affect the general features of the plant. The vast majority of plants growing in direct sunlight are termed heliophytes, whereas small plants communities growing in deeply shaded areas are called sclerophytes. The sclerophytes are very much affected by light. Some heliophytes which are capable of growing even under shade condition are called facultative sclerophytes. Means the heliophytes which grow in shade, they are called facultative sclerophytes. And those which cannot do so are called obligate heliophytes. Obligate heliophytes means the plant which does not grow in shades. Sclerophytes which can grow in sunlight are called facultative heliophytes. In the sclerophyte means shade, the plants which grow in shade, when they grow in sunlight, they are called facultative heliophytes, and those which cannot do so are called obligate sclerophytes. Means the sclerophytes which does not grow in sunlight, they are called obligate sclerophytes. In dry climates, the vegetation is facultative or obligate heliophytes, where In moist climate, vegetation consists of series of superimposed layers of tall tree, low trees, shrubs, herbs, mosses, and a high percentage of the flora are facultative or obligate sclerophyte. Then the effect of light on movement. Light affects the movement of some plant. The stem, roots, and leaves show different response to light. The effect of sunlight on plant movement is called heliotropic effect. In the effect of sunlight on the plant movement is called heliotropic effect. The stem elongates towards the source of light positively, phototrophic, and the roots are negatively phototrophic. The leaves grow transversely to the path of light in order to receive maximum sunlight. The leaves are oriented on the stem in such a way that they do not overlap one another. Then effect of light on germination of seeds. The seeds, when moist, are very sensitive to light. In some cases, the germination of seeds is retarded or inhibited in light. The quantity of light needed for the stimulation of embryo varies in different seeds. In most cases, the red light promotes germination and far red light inhibits germination. Seeds of certain plants require blue light for germination. Germination of typha seed is promoted in yellow light. Yellow light counters the inhibitory effect of blue light. Then the effect of on the production of chlorophyll. Light is necessary for the formation of plant pigments. A primary response of the plant to light is the production of chlorophyll. Plants with plastid produce chlorophyll only in light, and the chlorophyll practically disappears in continued darkness. However, chlorophyll does not develop in response to the light. In bacteria, fungi, cuscuta, and some other parasites and saprophytes. Effect on number and position of chloroplast. Light has a very strong influence on the number and position of chloroplast. The upper part of the leaf, which receives full sunshine, has larger number of chloroplasts, which are arranged in line with the direction of light. These chloroplasts arrange themselves in a number of layers and screen each other from the full effect of radiant energy. In leaves of plants which grow under shade, chloroplasts are very few in number and are arranged at right angle to the light rays, thus increasing the surface of absorption. Then the effect of light on leaf surface. The leaf surface undergoes greatest modification in response to light than any other organ of the plant. Differences in the thickness of leaves grown in the sun and the shade are usually very clearly marked. Thickness of the leaf increases with the increasing light intensity. The form of leaf is largely determined by the action of the light upon the chloroplast, and consequently changes in the form of cells that contain them. Light also affects the differentiation of palisade tissue and spongy parenchyma tissue in the leaves. Spongy cells tend to produce an extension of leaf at right angle to the incident light. Incident light means the light which is falling on the leaf, while palisade cells extend the leaf in the direction of the incident light. Hence, leaves that contain excess of spongy tissue are relatively broader, while those in which palisade is more are relatively thicker. Means that leaves having number of spongy tissue are broader, and the leaves having more palisade, they are thicker. Effect on growth. Growth is most common factor of life. In strict sense, growth implies the permanent accumulation of materials utilized by the plant for the building up of new tissue. Light is necessary for growth, yet stem shows greater elongation in the darkness than in the light. More rapid growth takes place at night. In dicot plants grown in continued darkness, the stem elongates rapidly but remain delicate and weak with long internode. Plants grown in strong light remain short and stocky and present a healthy look. Growth is also affected by the quality of light. Plants grown under red light attain maximum height and appear to be etiolated, whereas plants grown under blue light are small and compact but otherwise show normal growth. Then the effect on development of flowers, fruits and seeds. Intensity of light has very pronounced effect on the development of flowers, fruits and seeds. Diffused light or reduced light promotes the development of vegetative structure and causes delicacy. Vegetative crop like potato, carrot, turnip and beets give highest yield in regions with high percentage of cloudy days. Tobacco plants are grown under artificial shading to get larger leaves needed for making cigars. Intense light favors the development of flowers, fruits and seeds. The great profusion of flowers in grassland throughout the growing season is largely due to strong light. Similarly, larger number of bright colored red flowers is found in alpine meadows where the light is very intense. Then last effect of light, it is effect on the distribution of plant. According to Krebs, light does not act as a limiting factor in geographical distribution of plant. Light does, however, play an important role in determining local distribution of plants. Plant species become adapted to live in a certain kind of habitat, and in this process evolve a series of characteristics which prevent them from occupying other habitats. Grimm suggested that light may be one of the major components directing these adaptations. However, the local distribution of plants is affected by the duration and intensity of light. In sea, for example, the vegetation diet differs at different depths as light intensity goes on decreasing. Similarly, on land, the vegetation in polar regions is different from other regions. This is about the effect of light on plant. Thank you.